Unit 4, Principles of Insurance, Lecture 3, Long-Term Insurance. Long-Term Insurance. The Long-Term Insurance Act makes provision for 6 classes of insurance: assistance policies, disability policies, fund policies, health policies, life policies, and sinking fund policies. Payment of premiums. If the insured failed to pay the premiums on the due date, the insurer must inform the policyholder of non-payment. The policy will remain in force for a period of time, but the period for which it remains in force differs depending on the frequency of a recurring payment. If premiums are paid 1 month or less, the policy will remain in force for 15 days after the due date. If premiums are payable at intervals of longer than a month, the policy will remain in force for 1 month after the due date. If the overdue payment is still not made and the value of the policy is greater than half of all the premiums due during 12 months from the date of the unpaid premium, the insurer must inform the policyholder of the remaining value of the policy and notify them that the policy will remain in force until the policy no longer has value or until the payment of premiums is resumed. According to Section 54 of the Long-Term Insurance Act, there are certain limitations imposed on long-term policies. For example, policies on the life of a minor or an unborn child is a maximum aggregate death benefit for an unborn and under the age of 6 child of 10,000 Rand, and for a child 6 to 14 years old, a maximum limit of 3,000 Rand. Policy provisions that are void. Provisions that exempt the insurer from liability for the actions, omissions or representations of a person acting on his behalf have the effect of declaring that a person who acts on behalf of the insurer was in fact appointed to act on behalf of a policyholder, and any provision that have the effect of waiving any right that the policyholder has under the Long-Term Insurance Act. Section 63 of the Long-Term Insurance Act relates to the protection of policy benefits in the case of insolvency and applies to life, disability, assistance or health policies on a condition that whether person or spouse of person is a life insured and which the case the policy has been enforced for at least 3 years. Insurers are taxed under the five funds approach according to Section 29A of the Income Tax Act. The five funds are untaxed policyholder fund, taxed at 0%, individual policyholder fund, taxed at 50%, company policyholder fund, taxed at 28%, a corporate fund, taxed at 28%, and lastly, a risk policy fund, taxed at 28%. Disability cover provides cover for temporary or permanent incapacity resulting from injury or disease to the extent that an individual can no longer perform the occupation or reasonable other occupation. And it can provide for capital, meaning a lump sum, or income, monthly benefits. Benefits may be provided under an individual policy or a group scheme policy. Impairment cover is a new generation form of disability cover, and the benefits are paid out under specified degrees of impairment or inability to perform daily activities. Critical illness cover is designed to pay out when a policyholder has an illness or suffers a traumatic event which results in financial difficulty. Examples of these are a heart attack, cancer, paraplegia or blindness. And in these cases, a capital sum will be paid out. Typical exclusions are any incidents or illnesses through attempted suicide or self-inflicted injuries, consumption of alcohol or drugs, and willfully violating any law, including a riot, war, and engaging in hazardous sports.